Good morning all. Today we are going to start the first module of differential equations. You have already learned about differentiation, partial differentiation, and you know what is an equation. And now we are going to connect all these things. We have an equation with one or more variables that relates the function itself and its derivatives of various orders. The differential equation has very much applications in the areas of physics and engineering, and also in some economics applications, biological applications also, etc. So we are going to the introduction of differential equations. So first, the definition itself: a differential equation is an equation that means it has an equal to sign that relates one or more variables that relates the value of the function itself and the derivatives of various orders. It has numerous applications in physics, engineering, and econometrics. When a physical phenomenon expressed in mathematical terms, the relations are equations, the rates are derivatives, and the equation containing derivatives are differential equation. We have some equation connecting to the mathematical phenomena, and we have whenever a rate of change is there, the derivatives will be there, and the equation joining these two, the relation and the derivatives, it's the differential equation. The mathematical application of differential equation is known as the modeling. This is called modeling. By definition, it is modeling is the process of writing differential equation to describe a physical situation. Now we have to, the procedure to construct a model is identify the independent and dependent variables and assign letters to represent them. Usually we are using x, y, t variables. Now choose units of measurement for each functions. If we have velocity, it will be meter per second. If it is acceleration, meter per second square. Force, it's newton, something like that. As choose new units also. Step 3, articulate the basic principle that underlies or governs the problem you are investigating. Now, in step 4, express the principle or law in step 3 in terms of variable you choose in step 1. Now, we have the concept of direction fields. The method of direction fields or slope fields is a graphical method for displaying the general shape and behavior of solution of differential equation of the form dy by dt is equal to f of t y, where f is a function of two variables t and y, sometimes referred to as the rate function. Now we have solutions of differential equation. Consider the differential equation dy by dt is equal to ay minus b. We can rewrite as dy by dt is equal to a into y minus b by a, that is dy by dt by y minus b by a is equal to a. We can apply the chain rule in the left side, then we got d by dt of ln of modulus of y minus b by a is equal to a. Then if we integrate the all term, we get ln of modulus of y minus b by a is equal to at plus c. We can take the exponential, then we got modulus of y minus b by a is equal to e raised to c into e raised to at, and y minus b minus a is equal to, we can avoid the modulus, plus or minus e raised to c e raised to at. Therefore y is equal to b by a plus c e raised to at, where c is equal to plus or minus e raised to c. All possible solutions of a differential equation is known as the general solution. Here y is equal to b by a plus c raised to at is the general solution. Now in the general solution, when c equal to 0, it is known as the equilibrium solution. The geometrical representation of the general solution is an infinite family of curves called integral curves. In the general solution, we can use additional condition at time t equal to 0, that is y of 0 is equal to y naught, to determine c is called the initial condition. We have a differential equation and we can apply the condition at time t equal to 0. This condition is known as the initial condition to determine the unknown coefficient in the general solution. Now we have classifications of differential equation. The first one is ordinary and partial differential equation. So in a differential equation, if we have only one single independent variable, so we have only ordinary derivatives involved in the differential equation, then it is called an ordinary differential equation. Example, d square y by dx square plus 2x dy by dx plus y equal to 0, dy by dt all square plus 2t dy by dt minus y is equal to 0. For the differential equation, dy by dx is equal to f of x, x is the independent variable and y is the dependent variable. A partial equation involving more than one independent variable and hence partial derivatives in it is occurred in it is called a partial differential equation. Example, uxx plus uyy plus uzz equal to 0. That is dou square u by dou x square plus dou square u by dou y square plus dou square u by dou z square is equal to 0. T square dou square u by dou t square minus x dou u by dou t all square minus sin t dou u by dou t is equal to 0. Now we have systems of differential equation. In some differential equations, two or more unknown functions involved, and more than one differential equation known as system of differential equation is required to solve them. Example, 5dx by dt plus 5 plus dy by dt is equal to 8x, dx by dt minus dy by dt equal to 8y. Here two equations are there with the independent variable t. Next is example is 2dx by dt plus dy by dt plus 60dz by dt is equal to 7. Dx by dt plus 8dy by dt is equal to e raised to z. Dx by dt plus dz by dt is equal to 7z. Here three differential equations are there. Here t is an independent variable and x, y, z are dependent variable. Now the order and degree of a differential equation. The order of a differential equation is the order of highest derivative occurring in the equation. The degree of a differential equation is the power of the highest order derivative involved in the differential equation after rationalized. Example, y square plus x d square y by dx square plus 2y dy by dx all square is equal to 7. Here we have to consider the highest order term in the expression. Here d square y by dx square is the highest order term and its order is 2. It's a second order and its power is 1. So degree is 1. So this is a second order differential equation of degree 1 and its ordinary differential equation. Next example is dqy by dx cube plus 3d square y by dx square plus 3dy by dx plus y equal to x. Here highest order differential term is dqy by dx cube and its order is 3. So it is, and its power is 1. So it is a third order degree 1 ordinary differential equation. And the next example is dou square z by dou x square plus dou cube y by dou square z by dou x square is equal to 0. Here the highest order term is second degree and this is a second order partial differential equation. Now we have one more classification, linear and non-linear differential equation. So any linear differential equation of degree n can be written as a naught t y of n, a1 t y n minus 1 plus etc, a n minus 1 t y dash plus a n t y is equal to phi of t, where a naught t, a1 t etc, a n t and phi of t are functions of the independent variable t. So example is d cube y by dx cube plus 3 d square y by dx square plus 3 dy by dx plus y equal to x. So all terms are linear. Next example is d raised to 4y plus dx raised to 4 plus 3 dx square y by dx square plus 3 dy by dx plus sin xy is equal to x e raised to x. This is also a linear expression. Next, a partial differential equation of linear t square dou square u by dou t square minus x dou u by dou t minus sin t dou u by dou t is equal to u. Now, a linear differential that is not linear is called a non-linear differential equation. Example is d square y by dx square plus 3 dy by dx plus y square is equal to 0. Here, y square is the non-linear term. Next example is d cube y by dx cube plus 3 d square y by dx square the whole square plus 3 dy by dx plus y equal to 0. Here, d square y by dx square the whole square is the non-linear term in the expression. So, the given differential equation is non-linear. In the next example, d square y by dx square plus 5y dy by dx plus y equal to 0. The y dy by dx, the product of y and dy by dx is the non-linear term in the differential equations. Next, we have solutions. Consider the nth order differential equation f of t y y dash y double dash etc. y nth derivative y n is equal to 0. We can take this as equation 1 where f is a real function. A solution of equation 1 on the interval alpha less than t less than beta is a real function phi such that phi dash phi double dash etc. phi n exist and satisfy the equation 1, that is f of t phi of t, phi dash t, phi double dash t, phi etc. phi n t equal to 0 for every t in alpha less than t less than beta. Now we have three problems. The first problem is show that the function f of t is equal to 2 sin t plus 3 cos t is a solution of the differential equation y double dash plus y is equal to 0. You have to show this is f of t is a solution if f double dash plus f of t is equal to 0. We have to find f dash t first. F dash t is equal to 2 into in derivative of sin t is cos t plus 3 cos t. Derivative of cos is sin. So minus 3 sin t. Now f double dash t is equal to derivative of 2 cos t is minus 2 sin t. Derivative of 3 sin t is minus 3 sin t is 3 cos t. Consider f double dash t plus f of t which is equal to minus 2 sin t minus 3 cos t plus 2 sin t plus 3 cos t which is equal to 0. Therefore, f of t is equal to 2 sin t plus 3 cos t is a solution of y double dash plus y is equal to 0. Next problem is determine what value of r the given differential equation y triple dash minus 3 y dash plus 2 y dash equal to 0 has a solution y is equal to rt. So we have to find the value of r in which y is equal to e raised to rt is a solution of this given equation. So y equal to e raised to rt is the given solution. So y dash is equal to r e raised to rt and y double dash is equal to r square e raised to rt and y triple dash is equal to r cube e raised to rt. Therefore, y triple dash minus 3 y double dash plus 2 y dash is equal to r cube e raised to rt minus 3 r square e raised to rt plus 2 r e raised to rt which is equal to we can take out r e raised to rt to outside. So this becomes r square minus 3 r plus 2 is equal to 0. which implies equal to 0. Implies either r equal to 0 or r square minus 3r plus 2 equal to 0. Which implies r equal to 0, or this term we can write as r minus 2 into r minus 1. Sum is equal to minus 3, product equal to 2. Which means r equal to 0 or r equal to 2 or r equal to 1. Next problem is, show that the function u of xy is equal to ln of x square plus y square is a solution of the differential equation uxs, partial differential equation uxx plus uyy equal to 0. So we have to find ux first. Ux is equal to derivative of ln of x square plus y square, which is equal to 1 by x square plus y square into derivative of x square is 2x. Similarly, uy is equal to the same step, 1 by x square plus y square into 2y. Now uxx is equal to, we have to apply the quotient rule. So x square plus y square all square in the denominator, numerator x square plus y square into derivative of 2x is 2 minus 2x into derivative of x square plus y square, again 2x, which is equal to 2x square plus 2y square minus 4x square. So which is equal to 2y square minus 2x square divided by x square plus y square the all square. Now uyy is, we have the same step. So x square plus y square into, again quotient rule, all square, numerator x square plus y square into derivative of 2y is 2. We have to take the partial derivative. So only we have to take the derivative with respect to y, treating x as a constant. So 2y into derivative of x square plus y square is 2y. So this is 2x square plus 2y square minus 4y square. So 2x square minus 2y square divided by x square plus y square the all square. So uxx plus uyy is equal to 2x square minus 2y square minus 2x square by x square plus y square the all square plus 2x square minus 2y square by x square plus y square the all square. Now we have the x square plus y square the all square is the common term in the denominator. So 2y square minus 2x square plus 2x square minus 2y square. So this x square term and y square term cancel, so the answer is 0. Therefore uxy is a solution of the partial differential equation uxx plus uyy is equal to 0.